Hey, good morning to you. Come on in the house if you're outside. Amen. Had a great first service here. Very, very, very good first service. You're in for a treat today. You're in for a treat today. Especially from the worship team today. They got some great songs. Are y'all ready for some great songs? Some great music today. You're going to love it. And I'm going to preach a good message as well. So we're looking forward to it. Hey, man, if you need to wash your clothes, you can do that when you leave on the way out. We've got comfort stations out there. You can go to the bathroom. You can take a shower. You can wash your clothes. You can probably live in your car right out there. Some people might have to. That's okay. Our church is you'll see later. We've got some stuff that the church is doing, the whole campus is doing, and you're going to hear about it later, but because of people put out from the storm. So pretty interesting. We're just trying to be a blessing. Amen. And a lot of people didn't have damage, but if you were anywhere near water, tide water, you got it. You know, like us, I'm old Inglewood. I love old Inglewood. I love being near the water, smelling the water, seeing the water somewhere. Until then, I didn't like it as much because it got in the house a couple of times. But we're looking forward to a great day today. Amen. Let's jump up on our feet. Come on, here we go. Let's get on up and let's have church. Great day today. Looking forward to it. Pretty good crowd. And this one grows a little bit. We'll get more than this in about 15 minutes, but that's okay. We'll take it. Amen. If it's your first time at Fellowship Church, I'm Pastor Gary Clark. Welcome today. I'm glad you're here. You're welcome here. We love Jesus. We love people. If it doesn't have something to do with loving Jesus and loving people, we probably don't do it a whole lot. Okay? And so that's what it's all about. We want you to know that you matter here. You have value. There's no pecking order here. What does that mean? Well, just no pecking order. If you want to serve, you can serve. If you're a believer in Christ, when we have communion in a couple of weeks, you have communion. You don't have to be a member to be serving around here and to be involved. Y'all hear me? Yes or no? Okay? What you need to do is make sure you know Christ is your Savior. If you die, that you're going to heaven, that your sins are forgiven. That's the important one right there. Amen. And loving Him and in loving people. People need love in our world. Amen. In our town, we need it in our house. We need that. So that's who we are. Got a great band. They're called Saltwater Worship. They've been with us. They're just us. They're just us right out of our ministry. That's the original piano player for Fellowship Church 22 years ago. She's still right there. And there's he's one of the original worship singers, Mitchell Clark, from when we started the church at the high school. But he had to do it then because I made him. I made him back then. Now he does it because he wants to. I've had the bass player up there. He's been with me for about 20 years. And then I had Chris came along. Then Joel came along. And then Brian came along. And Sherry came along. And before you know it, we got us a team, don't we? Come on. Looking good, baby. Come on. And you came along. You came along. So we're so tickled. In a couple of weeks, we're having a big dinner on the ground, 22 years celebrating our church. It started in our house. And we're going to have fried chicken. We're going to go crazy. We do it. Right after church, it's going to be fun. There's going to be plenty of food. And it's going to be a lot of fun. Good time. But right now, it's time to have church. Let's put our hands together. Thank God we live in America. Don't give up. And get your tail out and vote. You hear me or not? They say Christians vote 40%. 40% of Christians. Let's do a quick poll. How many at the Fellowship Church going to vote? Let me see some hands. That look like about 100%. Amen. That's what I want. Don't y'all be bums. You hear me? Come on. We appreciate. Are y'all ready to have church? Come on. Let's thank the Lord. Here, just morning. Come on. Boom. Let's go. Praise the Lord.
Saved, find their way at the sound of your great name. Contempt, feel no shame at the sound of your great name. Everything
Praise the Lord with us this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. Stay standing on up. This is a song I saw. They usually send me the list, and I can see what they're singing before we ever have church on the weekend. And boy, this is one of my favorites. Get ready. Y'all ready or not? Get ready for a great song, and they go knock it out of the park. Jump on in there and help them. Chainbreaker. Come on. We need this song. Come on. Let's go.
Been walking the same old road for miles and miles. You've been hearing the same old voice tell the same old lies. If you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life. is a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, the saving, well, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. We've all run to things we know just ain't right. There's a better life. There's a better life. You got pain. He's a way maker. If you need freedom, save it. He's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. If you believe it, you receive it, you can feel it. Somebody testify. You believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you believe it, saved it. If you can feel it, somebody testify. If you got pain, well, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, save it. He's a prison shaking savior. He's a chain breaker. If you got pain, he's a pain taker.
Yes, he is.
If you feel love, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, save it. He's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, chain breaker. If you need freedom, saving, he is a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker.
Come on, church. Amen. I love that song, man. Remain standing with me just another moment. Again, thank you for being here. Thank you, guys. They'll be back in just a bit. Got a great special they're going to do, and it's one of Chris Brooks' favorite songs, so we're going to do that this morning. Then another one to close. But thank you for being here today. If you're watching online, we appreciate you with us as well. Send us a note if you don't mind. If you're watching online right now, just write us a little note of encouragement. But let's pray together. Come on. Lord, thank you for loving us. Thank you for saving us. Lord, thank you for individually seeking every one of us out. For me, it was 109 River Road, Rockingham, North Carolina, where you found us and you saved us, Lord. You came to our house. Your love, your message of hope, that you care for us, that we matter to you, that you don't want us to go to hell, but heaven's our home. It can be, and forgiveness of sin. Lord, I pray that for everybody in this room, and many have put their faith in you, Lord. But I'm sure many in this room are confused, or they've been taught some way that ain't the right way. They're putting their faith in church, Lord, or their good works. I pray today that they would know beyond a shadow of a doubt it's you, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, You're the one that died on the cross. You're their only hope. You're the world's only hope. We need you, Jesus. I pray right here at this service today, not one will leave lost, not one. Every one of us leaving here today will leave saved. We're going to leave on our way to heaven because we have our faith in you, Jesus. Help us, Lord. Would you humble us this morning in this service, down at your feet, so we can hear about ourselves, our life, what we need, not what somebody else needs, but us. Talk to us, Lord, today. We don't want to have church without you. Be in our midst, we pray. Encourage our hearts, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Y'all be seated. Thank you much. Praise the Lord. Mr. Alexander Christie has a lot of stuff for you. Go get him, buddy.
Good morning, everybody, and thank you so much for being here at Fellowship Church this morning. We're so very, very glad you're here. If today's your first time here, welcome. We're glad you showed up, you came out. You could have been anywhere this morning, and you chose Fellowship Church, so we thank you for that. We'd love to send you a note of thanks this week for being here. If you don't mind filling out that guest registry on your worship guide that you got when you walked in the door, or you can go on out to the Welcome Center right after the service and fill out the same basic info out there. And out there, they'll give you like a little gift bag with sunglasses, some notepads, pens from the church, and just some information about us as well. We promise not to bother you. We just want to send you that note this week and maybe a postcard three or four times a year, just letting you know when a big event is going on here at the church. So if you don't mind doing that, please do so this morning. And good morning, everyone online. Thanks so much for tuning in wherever you are in the world. Send us a Facebook message or an email, and we'll do the same thing for you. And please don't forget to put that Watch FC Live in your browser and save it in case Facebook goes crazy on us someday. We really appreciate it. Thank you. We got lots of Bible studies going on here at Fellowship Church. We'd love for you to plug into one, please. Nearly every day of the week, in the morning, afternoon, evenings, they're right there in your worship guide also. Or if you have any questions about it, give us a call at the office, and we'll fill you in on those details. We also have Friend to Friend every Tuesday here at the church. They're going to be meeting out toward the hospitality area starting this Tuesday for the foreseeable future. I'll get into more details about that in a minute, but it's just a really, really great chance to make some friends, play some games, and just create some relationships here at the church. So that's every single Tuesday at 1 o'clock right here at Fellowship. Every Wednesday, we have our Fellowship Recovery Group that meets right here at the church. They start with an incredible meal, all for free, out there in the foyer. And it's all about you coming in here, getting closer to Jesus so you can overcome your hurts, your hangups, any struggles you might have, and turn those burdens you have in your life into a blessing so you can praise God for getting over it and also help other people get through it as well. So please check this out every Wednesday. Incredible service. Love for you to be a part of it. And also on Wednesday, we have our Grief Share group. For anybody who's lost a loved one, we don't want you to do this alone. You don't have to do it alone. People will come alongside you. They will love you. They will encourage you. And it's just a really incredible group every Wednesday at 4 o'clock right here at the church. We all have a huge event coming up on Halloween. We're going to reclaim this in the name of Christ. We want to take this and have a chance to reach as many people in our community as possible right here at the church. If you don't mind signing up today on your way out to volunteer, to come out here and give candy, we're going to give tracts away to people. We're just going to love on people and have a good time doing it. It's going to be a lot of fun. Kim will be out there after the service. Love for you to sign up, be a part of this. We'd like to have 100 cars out there if we could. It would be awesome because what we do, the reason, in case you're new here, the reason why we do this is because Mark Twain goes crazy for Halloween, and they use our parking lot to go walk down Mark Twain. So we decided, let's turn our parking lot into a little bit of a situation where people have to walk through us to get to them. So it's just a really, really good thing, and we're getting the gospel out. Help us do that. It's an awesome thing. And we're also going to be down the way at Dearborn doing the Safe Walk as well, and I'm not sure if they have all the folks they need signed up for that too, but it's going to be great. Larry's going to be making chili down on Dearborn. I'm going to be making some chili all for free. We're going to have chili also right here at the church campus for folks. It's going to be a great, great day. Please be a part of it on Halloween right here at the church, and that's going to be running from like 5 to 7, just so you know. It's only like 2 hours. You can do it. Anniversary Sunday is coming up. It's the first Sunday of the month next month. 22 years as a ministry, praise the Lord. Isn't that amazing? It's incredible. 22 years. It feels like, it's weird how time is, right? Because it feels like it's a blink. Also feels like it's been forever. It doesn't make sense, right? Because I don't know my life without this church. But at the same time, it feels like we just started doing stuff. So we're just so grateful to have you all be a part of it. And we want to celebrate right after the 10:30 service on the first Sunday of the month. We're going to be doing a fried chicken, all the sides, dessert, everything. We just need you to sign up on your way out today so we have enough food for everybody. You can invite a neighbor, invite a friend. Just let us know about it, please. It's going to be an awesome event, all for free. We want to celebrate with you our 22nd anniversary. So please sign up on your way out today. This is also huge, folks. We got a cute little video coming up, but this is an awesome chance for you to reach the world. And let's go ahead and roll that video real quick, Roger, please. So when there's a catastrophe, Samaritan's Purse is there. And what they do is they roll in here with these boxes that we're going to ask you to take next week, starting next week. 1, 2, 3. Some of you take 10. And fill them up with stuff. There'll be a list. It'll help you out do that, you know what to put in there. And when they show up, they stay because they literally will plant something right in that community because they love the kids. They give the kids this free gift that you'll provide. And the gospel is given. And then these kids go home and they tell their parents how they were loved. And then the parents get interested. And that's how things happen. That's why we love Samaritan's Purse. When Ian hit Englewood, they were here. When this Milton rolled through, they're here. They're in North Carolina. They're wherever we need them to be. It's a great organization. It's one of the few big national ones that Pastor Gary really believes in and we support. So it's an awesome chance for us to give something to the whole world. We don't know where your box is going to end up. It could end up on the other end of the planet. We just don't know. But it's an incredible chance for you guys to do something mission worthy. And it's easy. And it's frankly, it's fun. Who don't like to buy kids stuff and pack it? So come on next week, if you don't mind, grab a box or 10 and fill them up, please. Okay? Thank you so much for that. This is our town. We have a mission focus here, right here in Englewood also. There's people here that need Jesus, and you can have a part in that as well by wearing a shirt, putting a hat on your head, putting a bumper sticker on your car. And you may think that's just silly, but it's not. I get asked every week about this church because I wear the shirt every day of the week. I just really, really would love for you guys to get out there and wear the shirts, do that, and point people here to Fellowship Church so Pastor Gary can tell them about Jesus. You can be a part of someone's testimony without really even trying. You just got to get dressed. So please, do us a favor. Grab one on the way out today. They're $5 a piece, the shirts, the hats, all that stuff. If you don't have the cash, we'll just give it to you. But please promise to wear it. And we also thank you for giving at Fellowship Church. We are a debt-free ministry because of you. Give2fc.com, really easy way to give online. And, of course, that P.O. Box, we thank you so much for all you folks up north who have stayed in touch, and they've been giving and tithing through that P.O. Box as well. The stuff that we're able to do here at Fellowship Church because of your generous giving is amazing. The Island Church, which is a middle school on Boca Grande, the Island School, thank you, Pastor, is a middle school on Boca Grande, K through fifth grade, and when Helena rolled through, it knocked out the water and sewer lines to the island, and then Milton did more damage. So they haven't had school since that first storm came through. They're starting here tomorrow. They're going to be using all the back classrooms, and they're going to be cramming six grades with kindergarten through first in four rooms out in the hallways and all that good stuff, and they're going to make it work. And we're able to do that and tell them there's no rent. There's nothing due. We just want to be a blessing. And if they can give something to help make ends meet a little bit, we'll be grateful for that. But we're not telling them, if you don't make a certain rent payment, you're not coming here. We don't do that. And it's because we're able to do that because of you guys and your faithful giving. So again, from the bottom of our hearts, we really, really do thank you for letting us be a ministry that can love people and not just say it, but actually do it. So amen. Thank you all so much. We love and appreciate you and hope you have a great rest of your day.
Thank you. Amen. The Island School, it's an elementary school, and it's kindergarten through the fifth grade, as he said. It's Boca Grande's little elementary school. And so they called us and asked if we could do that. They need a place. And so Alex called me, and I'm like, oh, no. But I said, no, we say we love Jesus, we love people, and there's an opportunity. Just means that Bible studies, we're going to be meeting in other places, out in the foyer, maybe even at our offices, whatever. But we can handle that for a couple of months. Amen? And also, yeah, praise the Lord. Amen. Good stuff. Amen. Praise the Lord. Boca Grande's in Lee County. It's hard to believe that's Lee County, but it is. And so this is going to be, it's a bona fide school. It's going to be here Monday through Friday, 5 days a week, 7:30 to 5 o'clock every single day. And they'll also have a Lee County police officer that will be here. And they have pickup, drop off. It'll be a secure site. And you see already we have comfort stations out front, showers, you know, washing machines. We didn't have to buy all that. We just have to be willing to let them come and be here on our campus. And we're willing to help people, amen? And it's a good thing. So praise the Lord, amen? Thank you for what you do, amen? And then one last thing. My wife will be out back today to sign up for Trunk or Treat, okay? I'd like to have 75 to 100 cars and trucks and SUVs lined up, and we're just going to load up and pull the back end up, decorate if you can, do stuff like that. If not, we'll give you some ideas to help you, but let's get out here and love these kids, amen, just love the snot. There'll be thousands coming, and just we're looking forward to it, so let's be a part of it, sharing Christ, loving the kids, loving our community. Come by and get you some hot chili. It's going to be good. Everything's free, free, free. Amen. That's coming up. But need you to sign up today. How many would say, I'm going to do that? Let me see somebody. I'm going to do that. And we need you. We need you. We want you to do this. Somebody's got to do something. We may as well do it. Amen. We'll represent Christ. We'll love them on Halloween night. And they're going to see when they come to this parking lot, there's people here that love the snot out of them. Amen. And that's the plan. Amen. Praise the Lord. Got a great song coming up. It's Rescue Story. And you see Chris Brooks is proud today. He's wearing that Georgia red. You see that? They did a number on Texas yesterday. It wasn't expected either. I mean, they were going in there, and a lot of people didn't give y'all a lot of hope down in Texas. Nobody gave you no hope. Nobody gave him any hope. It was Georgia against the world. Yeah, I know. I know. Chris had a shirt the other day. It said Georgia. What? What did it say?
Georgia.
Yeah, he had a shirt that said, Georgia versus all y'all. And I saw that shirt, and I told Chris, I said, man, you got to get me one of those. But I'm from North Carolina originally, so I wanted to say North Carolina versus all y'all. And so you know what he did? He got me one. He gave it to me today. So, but it's an XL trim. So for now, it's just a decoration. Let's tell the band we love them this morning. They got a great song coming. Here we go. Come on. Amen.
empty-handed, crying out from the pit of my despair. There you were in the shadows, holding out your hand. You met me there, and now where would I be without you? Where would I be, Jesus? You were the voice in the desert, calling me out in the dead of night, fighting my battles for me. You are my rescue story. You lifted me up from the ashes, carried my soul from death to life, bringing me from glory to glory. You are my rescue story.
How good is that song? What a great job. Beautiful. Amen. Praise the Lord. Stand on up with me one last time this morning, if you would. I know I work you hard, don't I? I don't know what other churches do. I don't know if they just sit around, if they stand up the whole time. I just do it the way I do it. Amen. You'll be fine. I'm here to help you. Here to help you. All right. Thank you for giving to the Lord's work here at Fellowship. We will receive an offering here in just a bit. Thank you for giving. Next week's offering, just to give you a little heads up, we usually give that last Sunday offering completely to our new building we're building, amen, for the future. We've raised about $1.5 million so far on that, and it will be done debt-free, totally debt-free for the Lord. his glory, credit, and all that good stuff. But next week's offering, instead of going to the building, we're going to do it for those that have been affected by the storm. Many people were flooded, okay? And if you're in the old town of Englewood, you were flooded. If you're in Grove City on the canals that come in there, especially on the bay side, you were flooded, okay? Grove City all the way down. And certainly down towards Placida and, you know, Boca Grande, Englewood Beach. A lot of people. And a lot of people didn't have insurance and things like that. So a lot of people were displaced. I have, every home I have had family in it. And everyone, we like the water. We like to be by the water, see the water, smell the water. Okay, somewhere near the water. We're just old Englewood people. And every one of them had damage. Every one of them. I said, it wasn't just my house. He's like, what? Anyway, but we're making it through it. But there's a lot of people have far greater needs than we have. So we're going to do that next week. I'm going to make a generous contribution myself, and maybe some of you others will do as well. Let's just see a crazy offering next week. Y'all hear me or not? Let's just give. Let's just give, because that could be us. That could be us having be totally displaced, amen? It'd be nice to help people. I'm going to tell you, one thing you don't want to go through is a flood. Be honest. How many, you have no idea what it is to go through a flood and lose everything from a flood? Can I see your hand? That's most people. I'd never had one 62 years. Had two in 2 weeks. Craziness. Anyway, but next week, that's what we'll do. Today's offer to go help meet the needs of our ministry, what we're doing right here. And if you can give cheerfully, we'll receive it. Amen. Thank you. One last song. Thank you guys for putting up with me, the band. I know I aggravate you. Hey guys, on the third of November, that's our big anniversary Sunday here at the church. Got it? And I hope that all of y'all can look at your schedules and make sure that your schedules will work on the third.
So we're still doing that?
Do what now?
We're still doing that?
Yeah, what I'd like to do is if we could on the third, I'm just having a business meeting right now. What I'd like to do on the third is I'll preach in the first hour with a couple of songs, so a couple of three songs from you like, or four, whatever. But the second hour, I'd like to turn the second hour into a full concert of just celebration.
We could have talked about this afterwards.
Do what now?
We could have talked about this afterwards.
Well, I don't know where you're at. I'm just saying.
I'll be watching football with you.
Yeah, well, we ain't got time to talk about that then. All right. Come on, buddy. Come on. Just keep that in mind. These people would love that on our 22nd anniversary, just to have a great concert before we go eat chicken. You hear me? Come on.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. You give life, you are love. Bring light to the darkness. You give hope. You restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath.
Thank the Lord with me this morning, would you? Come on. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Remain standing. Hey, Joel, I know you're getting out of here, but can you come up and lead us in prayer? Amen. Or just, yeah, thank you, buddy. Thank you for giving to the Lord's work, and you're just a big help to us. You make it happen. We appreciate it. And God has blessed us. We got a strong ministry financially. But if you can give cheerfully today, we'll receive your gift. If for some reason you can't do it that way, we ask you to hang on to it. If you're a single mom, or maybe you've been flooded, man, you just are really struggling. You don't need to worry about giving right now. All right, we're going to give. We can handle it, okay? We can take care. But you got a lot of people here that want to give and make a big difference. But we appreciate your giving. Joel, would you pray for us, buddy? Amen. Right down that mic. Thank you.
Father God, we just thank you for all those here this morning. We just thank you that we can come here and worship freely and hear your word and receive what you have for us, God. I thank you for just speaking to each and every one of us through the message this morning. I thank you that as we go out into our everyday lives this coming week, that you'll just use us and to touch those who are hurting, touch those who are lost, and bring those to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Be seated, please. Thank you much. Thank you much. If you're watching online today, again, thank you so much. We appreciate your giving here at Fellowship Church as you give online. It doesn't go unnoticed. We appreciate it. God gets all the credit, of course, but thank you, though, for giving. And maybe you can even write us a note right now of encouragement as you're watching. In about an hour or so, I'd read those. I love, love, love to hear from you. Thank you so much. Appreciate you. Thank you, Miss Karen. Everybody serving us today. Amen. Thank you so much. Are y'all ready to go to the Word? Yes or no? Yes. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm glad you're here at church today. Thank you. Had a really quite a bit larger crowd in the first service this morning. I don't know why that is. I don't give a hoot. Amen. Which service people come to. I just want you to come. But I had a strong day today, and appreciate you being here. Let's go to God's Word. In a series on favor. And I'll finish it up next week with a very strong message. Today's message, real practical, and probably not going to hit you too hard upside the head with this one. Pretty nice. Next week's message, a strong message. It's called Really Caring, Really. Really Caring, Really. That's next week, and I'm ready for it. But today's message is on something I touched on last week. In that passage of Scripture, we're talking about fighting our inward selves, our inward battle. If we want favor, we're going to have to fight for it. Would you say that out loud? If we want favor, we're going to have to what? Now, some churches teach that you can buy it with money. Yeah, some churches teach that you can just say it and you got it. There it is. I'm all for saying the right things. I'm all for trying to be positive. I get that. But I believe if you're going to have favor, you're going to have to work for it, and I believe you're going to have to fight for it. Jesus, the Bible says, he grew in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and men, or God and people. So when you know people, I mean, listen, you can't just throw money at people and get favor. Now, some people you can. You can buy them. But generally speaking, that's not the way you get favor with people. Most of our favor comes with people on how we treat people. Is that true, yes or no? Is that absolutely true? And the biggest part of favor, what causes us the most struggle with favor with people, is our mouth. Is that true? We say something, it can be a look, but a lot of times it's worse than a look. We give them a piece of our mind as well, and we wonder why they don't like us. We wonder why when we go to the restaurant, you know, they don't want to wait on our table. You know what I'm saying? You go to Publix, they don't want you to go through their line because of the way you talked to them last time. So favor, a lot of it has to do with how we speak to people, how we talk to people. So if we want favor with people, it's going to come through our actions. Is that correct? Yes or no? Amen. Well, I can just pray for favor with people. Pray for favor with people. If you treat people like a dog, you ain't getting none. You understand? In your marriage, I want favor in my marriage. God, give me favor in my marriage. If you're ugly to your wife or to your husband, you can pray till the cows come home. Your actions matter. Faith without works is what? It's deader than a doornail. And that's the book of James. We're talking about the book of James. We're studying the book of James, and we're looking at this book from the perspective of favor. And so that's what we're doing. We've been doing that. So today's message is about favor, again, with God and with people. But before we get to that, the last couple of messages we've had have been on fighting the battle within. Fighting the battle within. I mean, how can you have favor with God? What can you give God? Well, I'll give him some money. He needs money. God doesn't need your money. Okay? Listen, you know what you can give God? Give him your heart. Give him your life. How about give him this? Give him the respect that he deserves by obeying his word, confessing your sin, and fighting that battle of sin in your own life. That's the best gift that I can give God. And honestly, I believe God will give you favor as you fight your own demons in your own battle. Y'all hear me or not? Are y'all sleepy or is it just me? Is it just me? Okay, all right. I told the band back behind stage, I said, man, Clark is wore out today. I worked 5 hours at the office this week, and I worked about 75 in the field. You know, pulling trees and you name it, dealing with slop and junk and mess, and I did it all week long. I ran 2 crews on Monday. I say I ran them, had 16 show up over to Lisa and Miss Jenny's. I ran 8 in the front yard and 8 in the back. And I was the guy in the middle. And we had so much junk and mess and cleaning out. And yesterday I did trees, and I had the best tree trimmer in all of Englewood. I mean, the guy's crazy. With a chainsaw, he'll cut anything. But, you know, when he cuts it, you got to do what? You got to pick it up. Ah! It seemed like we did 20, 30, 40 loads. I don't know what we did. But I made the dumb idea of saying, I'll help empty every load. That was a dumb man. So I'm shot today, amen. But anyway, I'm going to make it through this message. Do I sound like I'm whining? Anyway. Yeah. So favor. Favor with God and people. Now, we've been giving all kinds of messages on this. We're about to wrap it up next week. But today's message I alluded to last week. It's called Live Today. Say that out loud. Live today. If you want favor with people today, if you want favor with God, it's going to happen today. It's not something we need to put off. And we're going to get in the book of James again. Let's see what we can find today. And I'd like you to say the verses out loud with me. These are great verses. Verses I've memorized over the years. It doesn't mean I'm better than you. It's just these verses matter. A lot of these verses matter to me, and I've hidden them in my heart. Let's say this one. Say it out loud with me. Go to now. You that say, today or tomorrow, we will go into such a city, we will continue there a year, and we will buy and sell and get gain. Doesn't that sound wonderful? Yeah, look. Plans. Keep going. Whereas you know not what shall be on tomorrow. For what is your life? Keep reading. It is even a what? Vapor that appears for a little time and then it what? Vanishes away. The title of my message today is Live Today. Live today. Live today. And that's what James is trying to tell us. If we want God's touch on our life, if we want God's blessing on our life, if we want the blessing of other people, the word favor means preferential treatment. The word favor means to be a favorite. If you want to be a favorite of people, and there's nothing wrong with that, I want to be the best dad in the whole world. I want to be the best dad when my kids, they say they've got the best dad. I miss that mark. I know I do. I want to be that kind of husband to Kim. I want to be the best husband. I want to be that way. I want to be the best pastor. You know what I'm saying? I want to love y'all. I want my heart to be open to you. I want you to know about me, and I'm not better than you. And I do this because I love you guys. You hear me or not? Say. And I don't have to talk that way, but this is the way I want to be. Okay? But I need to do that today. If I want favor, I've got to work at it today. And that's what this whole passage is about from my perspective this morning. We don't know what's going to happen when. Tomorrow. Okay? We have no clue what's happening on tomorrow. We don't even know if we're going to what? Anybody ever knew somebody, they were here one day and they were dead the next? That's going to be you. And it's going to be me. I'm 62. I am 62. You can laugh all you want. I'm 62, man. You know, I went out with a kid this week. He got saved here about 2 years ago. His name's Jacoby. Are you here in the service, son? He's here on the campus somewhere today. There he is. Yeah, there he is. You moved on me, man. But I was out eating with him the other day. He got saved here. I baptized him in my swimming pool about a year and a half, 2 years ago. And he went away to South Carolina, but he's got a heart. He wants to serve the Lord. He's got a heart for the Lord. And he wants to, go and consider ministry. And I said, well, I'll let him come, and he can intern with me for a little bit. And so I'm spending time with this young man. Went to Lemon Bay High School and on the weightlifting team over there. You played baseball, right? Yes, what position?
Center field.
That means you were pretty decent if you're in center field. You could run, brother. Amen. So I took him out to lunch the other day. I'm talking about getting old. I'm old. I'm out to lunch with him the other day, and so he tells his friends, his family back in South Carolina, he's coming to Florida, and he's looking forward to being able to spend time with me and stuff like that. And he says, you know what? Pastor Gary's like my grandpa. I nearly busted him in the mouth right in mama's. Wham! Your grandpa? I've heard people say, you're like my dad. Well, I can handle that. The bottom line is we're getting older. We don't know what tomorrow's going to bring. None of us are promised a tomorrow. We need to live today. You hear me? And I've got some points I'm going to make if this is sort of boring you. But we need to live today. We need to live in the now. Let's keep pushing it, Raj. What can we find? Say that verse with me. For that you ought to say, if the Lord wills, we shall live and do this or do that. See, that's God's will. We need to live in the now. Today is all we've been given. This is it. And you're going to see that in just a minute, what I'm talking about. Say that one with me. But now ye rejoice in your boastings, all such Rejoicing is evil. What kind of rejoicing? We're rejoicing and we think we got it tomorrow. It's okay to make plans for tomorrow. I get that. A doctor's appointment tomorrow. You're going to see somebody later this week. I get that, guys. But, man, we need to live in the now. That should be the way we live. We should keep short sin accounts with God. If we want favor with people, we need to treat people right when? When? Tomorrow or today? We need to do it right now. Presuming on tomorrow is evil. That's what the Bible says. Us living our life like we've got a tomorrow. A lot of people don't have tomorrow. We had, I think, 5 or 6 motorcycle deaths in the last year in the greater Englewood area. I did 2 of those funerals. Just boom, dead. Recently had a call. Lady was getting into bed, going to bed, and she's getting into bed and fell over on the bed, face down, dead. We just act like, I'm just going to bed. I'll see you in the morning. You don't have a clue who you're going to see in the morning. We need to start living as if today could be our last day. You want the favor of God, then live as if today is your last day. You'll treat people better, and God will bless you if you get more out of your day. Say that with me. I'm driving you crazy. Therefore, to him that knows to do good and doeth it not, to him it's what? It's sin. So we need to do right, and we need to do right today. So not doing good today is a what? Putting off something. I'm going to call somebody. Why don't you do it today? Say, I'm going to give something to somebody. Let's just check it out. We're going to get into some of that. Life becomes so much more precious to people. Say that part with me. When they what? Have you noticed that out of people? They get cancer. Especially if it's stage 4 and it's terminal. And I understand. I understand why they're trying to live life. And they're trying to squeeze every bit of life they can. But man, that's how we should live all the time. Us presuming that we're going to have all this time, God calls it sin. So why do people live like that? Well, because they don't have what? They don't have much time left. And so the question begs the question today is, why do you think you do? What makes you think you've got time? Has anybody ever known somebody in their 30s to die? Let me see some hands. Somebody in their 30s. How about 40s? How about 50s? How about 60s? 70s? 80s, 90s. Here's the point. People die all ages. We need to live today. You want favor with God, then putting off doing right today, what you could do today, you're not going to have God's favor. You want favor with people, and you could do right by people today. You want their favor, then do it when? Do it now. So what makes us think we have so much time? We don't. We're just pushing. You don't have to lose it to live it. Say that out loud. You don't have to what? No, I don't have to get cancer to start caring about my family. You hear me? I don't have to get a terminal illness to get right with God. I can get right with God right now. That's what God wants out of my life. This is the only day I know I have. This is it. This is it. Had a sweet, where is Ray Lynn? Ray Lynn, are you here? Is she back in the back? How old is she? How old? She's 8 years old. She came up to me with a beautiful note telling me that she's so glad I'm her pastor. And she colored. Now, she does that often. And then sometimes she'll take her note and she'll stick with it a McDonald's card. And I think she takes her own money and does it. Okay? Her own money. 8 years old just to bless the pastor. She did that today. But you know what? She gave me a note today. But then she had a check with it. And she said, can you give this to Mitch? How old was she? 8. Well, an 8-year-old can't do that. Well, why can't an 8-year-old give? Maybe they're looking at us too much and they see that we're pitiful. If we give them an example that we're giving people and we're loving people and we care for people, we might could just change our world. Amen. An 8-year-old. What a beautiful story. I'm alive, man, today, so I know I got this one, but I don't know what's on tomorrow. Now, I want to switch gears real quick, and we're going to go. We're not going to be here all day, okay? Live today. I want you to really zone in with me now. Today's the only day you've got. What should I do today? What should I do today? I want God's favor. What should I do today? Say that out loud. Be what? Be saved when? Today. You're here. Maybe you've been coming for weeks, months, I don't know, years. But you're here, and somehow, I don't know how you've been here that long and haven't got it through your thick head that Jesus Christ is your only hope. You must be born again. Who said that? Jesus said it. Yeah, you must be. There's no way for a man or woman, boy or girl, to miss hell other than by putting your faith and trust in Jesus Christ. Well, I go to church. I don't give a hoot. I give money. Doesn't matter. You must put your faith in Christ. When should I do it? Take a wild guess. Today. You hear me or not? You're trusting in your good works, what you've done, some experience you've had, some feeling you've had. Do you know Christ as your Savior? He died on the cross. He rose from the dead. What does the Bible say? He that has a son has what? Life. He that has not the Son of God has not what? Life. Got it? If you'll confess with your mouth the who? Lord Jesus. And believe in your heart that God raised who? Jesus from the dead. You shall be what? Saved. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be what? Saved. There's no other way to get to heaven other than Christ. Got it or not? Well, I don't know about that. I was baptized. You're lost. If you're putting your faith in communion, baptism, catechism, some spiritual experience you had, you got all spooky one time, I could give a rip. Do you know Christ as your Savior? Are you? Maybe I'll get saved on my deathbed. Your deathbed could be today. Make sure you know Christ today. How many know that at close of every service, I invite people to come to Christ? How many know that about me? Well, we're going to do it different today. We're going to do it right now. I want you to get saved right now. I want you to know Christ right now. The Bible says, if you'll confess with your mouth, let's pray, and believe in your heart, that's down in your gut. Guys, I love you, and I love you coming to Fellowship Church, but just coming here and getting some warm, fuzzy feeling ain't gonna cut it. You need to know Christ, especially men. Guys, you need to be saved. Are you hearing me or not? You need the Lord. You need the Lord. I used to think going to church was sissified and all that mess. That's all a devil's lie. You need Christ. Would you humble yourself right now? You want the favor of God on your life? Would you humble yourself right now and put your faith in Christ? I want God's blessing on me. Listen, He wants to bless the snot out of you. He wants to forgive all your sins and cast them as far as the east is from the west. He wants to write your name in the Lamb's Book of Life. He wants you to forever know, I'll never go to hell. People say, you go to hell. You say, hell no, I can't go. That's the plan. God loves you. Amen. Would you humble yourself right now and be saved? You might say, well, I think I'm saved. Would you nail this today? Can we bow our head right now and do that? Let's pray together. Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, talk to Him. I know I'm a sinner. I am. I've done lots and lots and lots wrong, Lord. And I ask for You to forgive me. This is the only day I know I have, and I want to be saved right now today, Lord. I don't understand it all. You know I don't, Lord. Talk to Him. But, Lord, I understand this. You're my only hope. You're my only hope. Church isn't going to save me. My good works isn't going to save me. But You died on the cross, Lord. You rose from the grave, Lord, and You love me. And I'm putting my faith in You, Jesus Christ. You, Jesus Christ, and You alone. You are it. And I ask You to come into my heart, live into my life. I want to follow You with my life. I want to live for You, Lord. I'm putting my faith and trust in You. You did this. I didn't do it. You did it. So I'm following You. I'm putting my faith in You. And I do that today in Jesus' name. Amen. Got it? Let's go to another point. Okay? I'm talking about living in the now. Let's look at that scripture. For he that said, he's about being saved. For He says, I've heard you in a time accepted. In the day of salvation have I helped you. Say that last part with me. Behold, now is the what? Accepted time. Behold, now is the what? You might say, Clark, why'd you pray with people like that? Because today's the day of salvation. Today's the day of salvation. There's no reason you have to go to that car, turn that key lost. Okay? Number two. Let's put up another one. Today's the only day I have. So I need to do what? When? Well, I'll do it later. Why? What's the Bible say? If we confess our sins, He's faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Maybe there's something in your life, there probably is, something in your life right now that's not right. It is not right. You know it. It's not good. You can get that forgiven right now today. Did you hear me, yes or no? You can confess that right now. Let's bow our head. I'm going to do it with you right now. I'm going to do it with you right now. I know this is different. This ain't the way I normally do stuff. I don't give a hoot. I think we're going to do it right now. Wouldn't you like to get right with God right now? Say, I'm at church. Why not get right with God right now? Say, let's bow our head. This is you. I don't know what's going on in your life. I have no clue. Okay? Why don't you talk to him about it for just a moment? Something like this, Lord, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me. Forgive me, Lord. I'm wrong about this. And I ask you to forgive me, Lord. It's me. I'm the one. And I'm confessing this, whatever it is, to you. You know it. You see me naked. You know everything about me. And pulling the wool ain't gonna fool you. And so I ask for your forgiveness, Lord. Help me. Help me. Help me with the battle that I fight. Help me with the temptation or the struggle I have. I confess this to you, Lord. I need you. I want your forgiveness and I want your help. In Jesus' name. Amen. How many think I've gone crazy? Clark's gone crazy. He's praying all throughout the sermon. Let's do another one. The Bible says, we saw that verse already, get right with God today. Amen. Let's do another one. Get right with who today? Okay? How many are holding a grudge against somebody? Maybe it's not a grudge. Maybe somebody did something wrong to you. I don't know what it might be. But it's hurt your relationship in a bad way. We learn from the book of James that if we'll humble ourselves, He'll lift us up. So what's the chance of you calling somebody today or going to see somebody today and getting right with them today? Most of the wrong we have is right in our house. Amen. We should get right with others when? I'll do it tomorrow. Call them tomorrow. You're a lunatic. And you're a bum. You can do it today. You hear me or not? Say, what's it going to hurt? What's it going to hurt to try to get right with somebody today? You don't hurt anything? Here's what the Bible says, Jesus speaking. If you bring your gift to the altar and you remember that a brother has ought against you, you ought to leave your gift there at that altar, go your way, and be reconciled to your brother, and then you come and give your gift and do your church thing. Amen. So get right with others when? Today. Let's look at another. Today's the only day we have. Love family and friends when? Love your wife, love your husband, love your children today. Love your friends today, okay? Don't let aught go there. Don't let problems go there in your family. And it has in mine. I've done it. It's awful. It's terrible. We need to get right with people today. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone that loves is born of God and knows God, okay? We need to love our family and friends. Beloved, if God so loved us, we ought to do what? Love one another. Amen. Praise the Lord. Say that with me. When? Today. Okay? If you serve here at this church in any capacity, you need to learn to be the first to encourage. You need to be the first. Hello? How are you? People standing back at the door with your little flyers you're giving out people. Don't wait for people to come up here. Hello, how are you doing today? Hug people's neck. This is how we should be in life. We should be a blessing to people. Are y'all hearing me or not? I go to a restaurant. I sit like a knot on a log. What are you doing? Talk to people. Say thank you. That's nice. I appreciate it. Encourage people. Put your arm around somebody. When? Tomorrow or today? Had a young man come see me after the first service. Looked like death warmed over, okay? All bent out of shape, messed up in his life. He's down, doesn't think anybody likes him or cares about him. It's all up here, man. It's all up here. All up here. But there are people like that all around us that we can put our arm around. We can bless. We can encourage. You want the favor of God? Do these kind of things. You hear me or not? I don't know about you today. Beloved, I wish above all things that you may prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. We as children of God ought to be lighting up our town. You hear me? I do it everywhere I go, and I'm not bragging on me. Anything I know, I learn from the Lord. He has helped me. He is, and I love on loving people. Is that right, Richard? Is that right, Jacoby? Yes or no? Anywhere we go, how many have ever been out to eat with me? Raise a hand again. You've been out to eat with me? Is that true? We're going to love on people? Did I sit there like a knot on a log with you that day? We're not going to do that. You might say, well, that's just your personality. I've had to work at this. We want to love people. We want to encourage people. We want to be a blessing to people. Amen? When? Do it. I know this ain't the easiest thing, but you're doing fine. Here's the last one, and I'm quitting. Give something away today. A lot of y'all got wills maybe and things like that, and you're going to give stuff away when you die. That's sort of a dumb idea. When you could give things, why don't you want to enjoy watching their face instead of the lawyer doing it when you're dead? Or some executor. Every man according as he purposes in his heart. Most people don't give because they don't purpose to do it. Every man as he purposes in his heart, so let him give. Not what? What's that word? Grudgingly. That means mad. Mad. I'm going to give, but I'm mad. A lot of church people give because they're mad. I got to do it. I don't want to. Or of necessity. That word means sad. I got to give, but it's killing me. You know what I mean? And then that last part, say that part with me. For God loves a what? And at Fellowship Church, we say, if you can't give what? Then keep it. I really don't want your mad money or your sad money. I'd rather have our glad giving. Why not give something today away? I got a challenge for you, and I've never said this before. You that live on high ground out in East Englewood, or maybe in Rotunda, Port Charlotte, why don't you take a car ride over to Old Town Englewood? Okay? Before you do, look around your house. Look around your house and look at all your furniture and look how everything looks so nice. Look at everything in your house. You probably don't even use so much of it. And take a ride over to where I live in that neck of the woods. Down Oxford, down Old Englewood, down South McCall. Go down towards Grove City. And these are nice. Some of these homes are big, beautiful homes. They're on the water, but they flooded. Those people have lost everything. Now, they may have insurance. Many people don't. I just think it'd be a good lesson for you. It can be gone just that quick. You hear me? And my challenge is for you to give something away today. And I'm not asking for myself. I'm just wondering how much we have if we went to people over there in that old town. They don't have a couch anymore. You might have three of them. I had at least two. Amen. My point is, it'd probably shock people if we went over there and started talking to them. And saying, you know what, I got a bedroom suit at my house that nobody ever sleeps on. I'd rather have an empty room in my house with no furniture in it so you could have furniture in your house. Do you think you might find favor with those people or not? Do you think you might find favor with God if you had that kind of attitude? Yes or no? Guys, this flood thing did something to me. I've had to handle everything. I hate that. It would have been better, I've said it, it ain't right, but it'd be better to have a fire. It's all burned up than having to take it and it's ruined and now you mean I got to touch it and take it out to the street? That's crazy. One thing I did find was my mother's Bible. And I didn't even really know where it was, to be honest with you. It was in my closet. And my mother's Bible that she read and underlined, it was just soaking wet. And you know what I did? I opened up that Bible. And her favorite verse is Romans 8:28. But I really opened it to Psalm 91. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High, you know, the Most High, who abides under the shadow of the Almighty. Talk about angels and you giving charge of angels over you and all that kind of good stuff. That was my mama's favorite psalm. And I opened it up, and boy, I got it open to there. And I could still see her underwriting in that, you know, she took her blue pen and underlined it. My mama. And I left it open right there to dry. If there's any pages, because they'll all stick together, but if there's any pages that would work, that's the one I want to work. And then I flipped, and I had put in some pictures. I only had a few pictures of my mother with my children, and they were in that Bible. And I pulled them out and separated them, you know, hoping that the pictures wouldn't come off on the back of the other one. And there was Mama with Elise. And I laid it up there to dry, and there's one with Mitch, and there's Mama down at the beach laughing. Last time I saw Mama alive. You know what I mean? But I got all those pictures. It's great. It's no problem. I got them. It's good. But so this has done something to me. You hear me or not? It's made me realize I've got so much crap. You never know how much crap you got. You got to haul it. You know what I'm saying? How many know what I'm talking about? It's crazy, ain't it? How many are hoping your house don't get hit by no flood because you got a lot of crap? What I'm trying to say is, how about we live in the now? How about if we got something, we start being more cheerfully giving people and start to give to people? Maybe some of you will take my challenge and you'll just ride over in the old town and you'll try to use your kindness and strike up a conversation with somebody. And they're hurting and they're traumatized. They might run you off their land. I don't know. Hope not. But the thing is, maybe you can just speak to somebody. Maybe you'll find something that they need and you can help them do it. When are you going to do that? Today. Why not? I think you could. Yeah. Let's thank the Lord. I think it's a good idea. Why not? Why not? Amen. Come on. Well, guys, thank you. Tomorrow's the favorite day of the who? Say that out. It's one of my favorite quotes. Tomorrow is the favorite day of the who? Lazy man. Let's thank the Lord for his word. We got to quit. Come on, guys. God bless you today. Amen. Let's get on up. Tomorrow really never comes, baby. If you get tomorrow, it'll be today. Amen. Miss Karen's not there. Where is she? There she is. There you are. Hey, I'm not going to be... I'm not going to be doing the typical invitation I normally do because we did it already. Amen? I'm right up front if you need me. But don't you stay with me. How about that song, Do You Know? You played it earlier. Do you have it? This is an old song, an old hymn. How many know that song, Do You Know My Jesus? A few of you? I'm going to sing the verse and we'll do the chorus. Have you a heart that's weary? Tending a load of care. Are you a soul that's seeking rest from the burden you bear? Do you know my Jesus? And do you know my friend? And have you heard he loves you and that he will abide till the end? Sing that chorus with me. Do you know my Jesus? And do you know my friend? And have you heard he loves you and that he will abide till the end. Lord, bless us. Lord, bless us as we go our way. Help us live in the now. Lord, I pray everyone that listened today is saved today. I pray none will leave this place, get in that car thinking they got another day. Pray today they'll nail that. Lord, I pray that all of us will get right with you today. We can do that here today. Lord, I pray we'll be committed to getting right with others today. We can do it, Lord. You're with us. If God be for us, who can be against us? Lord, help us love our family today, our friends today. Lord, help us, we pray. Lord, help us to care for people today. Lord, help us. We've got so much stuff. Lord, even with things we lost, I've got enough stuff to keep going just fine. It's crazy. And Lord, I bet I speak for most people. Your blessings, your blessings, your blessing upon blessing upon blessing. Help us be willing, Lord, to give it away. At least, Lord, help us try. We can try. We can try to help somebody. Lord, we want your favor on us. We want your favor on us. Lord, I want people's favor too. Help us, we pray, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you guys. Y'all have an awesome day. Amen. See you later. Thank you for coming out to church today. Listen to me. Appreciate it, guys. God bless you. I'm about half shot today, okay? See you later. Amen.